Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is wonderful to have you here. The welcome is from the College of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences. And this recital this evening is part of our arts residency program. There are flyers on the outside if you're interested in coming to see some of our other artists that will be in residence throughout the semester. We're awfully glad to welcome Cecilia Lopez and Nathaniel Salazar to our stage this evening. We've had a wonderful residency with them. Cecilia has taught some keeping items. Please turn your cell phones or any electronic gadget that you have to the stun mode or the silent mode. And we hope that you will enjoy this evening. Thank you for coming.
Hello. We didn't test this earlier, so I don't know.
Maybe is that the green light is on? Oh!
Okay. How it works. So this, first of all, thank you for being here. Thank you for coming and for supporting us and for the students. You guys are all almost as tall as I am, but or taller. But thank you for a wonderful week. I've enjoyed my time here, and thank you for just being so receptive to everything, and truly you guys have made this experience one that I will never forget. But I wanted to quickly say that this second half is a bunch of tunes that have enabled me to bridge my two worlds of classical music and the music that I grew up singing with my mom. And I believe that the order that we have in our binder might be wrong, and that's my fault. I'm so sorry. So the next piece is Estrellita, which is a Mexican composer. Manuel Ponce. There we go. See, all these things that are slowly coming back to me now. But to give you a little bit of history, I was never exposed to the classical music. And so being able to discover as I go in my career with, and just being exposed to this music that that's existed for years. It's really fun for me to be able to sing these old traditional canciones mexicanas, but with a classically trained voice. So here we go, Estrellita.
Thank you.
next piece is Amanecí Otra Vez. And the composer to this one, José Alfredo Jiménez, is a composer that basically identifies what the Mexican culture is. He was known for being like the top composer of Mexico, but all of his songs were for mariachi. And so when I found the sheet music and I asked Nate, it's like, well, can we play with this and see what it sounds like? And clearly, as you guys can see, Nate has been, he's a master at playing the ivories. And so when I gave him that sheet music, he just transformed it into something incredible. So here we go, Amanecí Otra Vez. I can kind of see you guys, but who knows the song Feliz Navidad? So raise your hand if you do. Feliz Navidad. Okay, so this next song is composed by, well, not composed by him. He was the first person that I ever heard sing this song. And so, and as we performed it, the last time I told the story, I cried, so I'm going to try not to do that again. This song, what the lyrics say, it's basically asking time to hold still because our loved one is going to be leaving the next day. And I went almost a year without seeing my kiddo, and it was, the more I sang this song, the more heartfelt it was to me, and I just, my thoughts immediately would go to her. But it was, I guess that's one of the things that I've been trying to teach the students this week is that you just try to, when you perform, just perform with the honesty of, and just be yourself and let yourself be vulnerable, and you make magic when you let yourself go there. But anyway, so reloj.
Thank you. Nick makes fun of me because I programmed these two songs and they're both sad to me. So he always watches me cry. So the thing is, I try not to make a lucky crying face at least. Sometimes I can't help it. But this next song, I performed the other day out here in the outdoor amphitheater, and it has that the story of my mom. It really ties me down to my roots because it was the first folkloric Mexican song that I was asked to sing and get paid to sing. but it was a full circle moment for me because when I realized what song it was, I called my mother and I told her, and to her disbelief, it just completely blew her mind because to her, opera and classical singing is just being up on stage and wearing costumes and playing dress up and, you know, and telling stories. But when I told her, it was one of those things that she and I shared, because that this song in particular is one of the songs that she taught me while we were working out in the beet fields in Little Rupert, Idaho. And those fields is where my mother instilled in me the love of music. She didn't train, she had a fourth grade education, and she was the one that was waking us up in the mornings and getting us out to those fields to work. And my brother and I, we hated being out there. We were grumpy, we were hungry, but mom was always the one that was pushing us forward and setting an example for us to follow. But she used music as something that was, I always refer to it as magic because I can't think of any other adjective to describe it. That's what it was. She would start singing and then the hours would go by faster, and then by the time we were done with the song, we were finished with a row, and then she would do it again. So music for me and my family, but mainly for my mother and I, it's been the one thing that's remained constant, even though I'm an opera singer now. I don't necessarily sing mariachi anymore. I'm singing at home with her. But for us, it's always been that foundation. And for her, it was her way of expressing her love. It was her way of helping us. My older brother and I, she was trying her best. And she knew, and I mean, what mother wants their children to be out in the fields? I mean, I was out there since I was itty bitty bitty. And so to see, I'm sure to my mother, to see her children out there in the fields with her, it probably was just as emotionally overwhelming for her. But you said this the other day, music does have that ability to tear down barriers and bring us all together. And that's what it did for us in those beet fields. So, la borrachita.
Thank you. think we've got one more piece for you, because it's who was here when they heard the story of Madame Butterfly with my mom and my dad and saying, Cecilia, I'm very proud of you. I can't, un baby.
Thank you.